About 8 months ago, I did one of my very first videos talking about the yellow spot on your eye you can get called a pinguecula, and I've gotten a lot of good comments and questions in that video. So I thought I'd take the top five most common questions about pinguecula and answer them in today's video. Let's focus in. Hey, howdy everybody, this is Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. Eye Guy, doing videos all about the eyes to help you with your eyes. Now let's get right into the top five questions that I've gotten about pinguecula. These questions will be in order of least to most common, so the last question is by far the most common question that I've gotten about pinguecula. Question number one, is a pinguecula affecting my ability to wear my contacts? And yes, it's possible it can actually mess with your contact lenses. If the pinguecula is close enough to the cornea, sometimes that contact will bump or rub up on the pinguecula and may push the contact lens around. It may cause a rotation. It may cause more excessive movement when you blink. And so that pinguecula can cause irregularities with contact lens wear. If your pinguecula is far enough away, kind of like mine is, then sometimes it won't even touch the contact lens. Or maybe if it's really shallow and smooth, sometimes the contact can drape over the pinguecula and be fine. But depending on the person, if the pinguecula is close enough and big enough, it can push that contact lens around and make it really annoying to wear contact lenses. Question number two, is there something that can be done for the yellow color of the pinguecula? Can you just get rid of the color so it's white? Unfortunately, there's not a way to get rid of the yellow color. Now that being said, a lot of times when you have a lot of vasculature or maybe the pinguecula is inflamed and beefy looking and irritated looking, you can calm down the inflammation, whether it's with eye drops or steroid eye drops, and it will get rid of that inflammation. And it does improve the color and that beefiness because it doesn't have a red inflamed look, but doesn't really necessarily get rid of the yellow color of the pinguecula. Number three, can the pinguecula be surgically removed? The answer to this one is yes. You can actually have the pinguecula surgically removed. Now, most of the time, I've seen the surgery reserved for people that have really, really bad inflamed pinguecula where it's elevated, it's causing a lot of irritation. Maybe when the patient is blinking, it's rubbing and touching the pinguecula. It's causing pain and a lot of issues. And so you can actually get it surgically removed to smooth out that tissue. Now, normally I haven't really seen much with a mild or a moderate pinguecula getting a surgery, but it is possible you can get it surgically removed. Before we get to the other questions, make sure you hit that like button down below so this will help the video get out, get awareness to the people that might have these same types of questions. Fourth question, this question was really common, almost tied with the top question that I've gotten, and that's if blue light or the screens can cause a pinguecula. People nowadays are spending a lot of time looking at computer screens or their phone screens. They hear a lot about blue light and artificial light, and they're wondering, hey, is that light actually causing my pinguecula? The answer there is no, likely not. Now, a pinguecula definitely can be egged on and caused by ultraviolet light, UV light that you can get from outside in the sun. Typically, screens aren't projecting ultraviolet light from the screens, and so you're not getting that damage that you'd get from ultraviolet light. Now, the blue light is a more high energy light that you can get from the screens, but that blue light isn't causing enough damage to cause that pinguecula. In fact, you'll get way, way more blue light when you go outside into the sun. Even in a short amount of time, being outside in the sun will be way more than the blue light that you'll get from your computer screens. Now, we may have more research that will come out and show that maybe the computer screens or that type of light may be causing damage on the surface of the eyes, but right now, it's likely not doing anything as far as developing a pinguecula. Now, I have done other videos talking about blue light, how it does affect your eyes, so make sure you check out my playlist right there. I go into more detail about how blue light may affect your eyes. Likely, more what is happening when you're staring at your screens, when you're staring at your phones, you're blinking a lot less and your eyes are drying out. The surface of your eye is drying out. And that's one of the biggest causes of the development of a pinguecula is eye dryness. And when you're doing a long period of time where you're staring at screens, if you're working on computer screens all day long, even from when you were a kid, your eyes, the surface of your eyes will be more dry, and that can actually lead to more of a development of a pinguecula. Now, the fifth question, the most common question by far, are there any eye drops that can cure or get rid of a pinguecula? The answer is no. I'm sorry, but no. Now, let me be very specific on this one. There aren't any eye drops that can completely get rid of a pinguecula, meaning if you have a yellow spot on your eye and you take eye drops for a certain amount of time, it won't get rid of that yellow spot. It won't cure a pinguecula. Now, that being said, eye drops are definitely one of the most recommended treatments for a pinguecula to help prevent a pinguecula from getting worse. Like I mentioned in the pinguecula video, I do mention that the biggest pinguecula treatments are definitely treating your dry eye issues, and that includes artificial tears, also protecting your eyes from UV light outside with sunglasses, hats, making sure that you limit how much UV light is getting onto the surface of your eyes. Those are the biggest treatments that you can do to treat a pinguecula, but biggest thing is to prevent the pinguecula from getting bigger, not necessarily getting rid of the pinguecula. And one thing I do want to mention about eye drops is sometimes when the pinguecula is really inflamed, there's a lot of redness involved. It's almost irritating and sometimes can be painful depending on how irritated it is. Your doctor can actually prescribe prescription steroid eye drops or prescription anti-inflammatory eye drops to get rid of the inflammation, to make the redness a little bit better, to calm it down, and to make it a little bit more tolerable. So just remember that if your eyes or your pinguecula is really irritated, inflamed, there are prescription eye drops that can help calm it down a little bit. And make sure that you check out the description below. I'll put links to certain eye drops that I prefer, that I recommend to my patients all of the time that are dealing with eye dryness and a pinguecula. Definitely recommend preservative-free eye drops. If you have a preservative-free eye drop, it tends to do better at treating the eye dryness. There's a little bit less irritation, especially if you're more sensitive to the preservatives in those types of eye drops, and it can help just reduce the irritation of that pinguecula. Now make sure you do check out the main video I did about pinguecula. There were many, many more questions that people asked me in that video, and I tried to answer them the best I could in the comment section there. But if you have more questions about a pinguecula, definitely leave them below. I try my best to answer all the questions that people ask me. Hey, and thanks for watching the whole video. I'm Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. Eye Guy, focusing on you and your eyes. Stay focused and be sure to check out my other videos right there, and I'll see you in the next video.